And now on to our dinosaur of the day, Auroraceratops, which was a request from Philip via Patreon, so thanks. It was a Neoceratopsian that lived in the Cretaceous in what is now North Central China and South Korea, and it was described in 2005 by Yu Li Ji, Lamanna, and Dodson. The name means Dawn Horned Face, and it's a combination of the fact that it's an early Ceratopsian, and it's a reference to Dawn Dodson, who's Peter Dodson's wife, and Peter, as I just said, was one of the paleontologists who described Auroraceratops. And Aurora means dawn in Latin, which is the early Ceratopsian part.
That's nice that he named it after his wife.
Mm-hmm. The type species is Auroraceratops rugosus, and the species name means rough in Latin, and it refers to the rough areas on the skull and jaw. There's only one known specimen of a subadult, and it consists of a nearly complete skull. It had a shorter, wider snout compared to other Neoceratopsians, and the snout was high and round, and the skull was flat and wide. The rough parts of the skull were probably covered in keratin, which may have helped protect it in butting or pushing contests if it was fighting for dominance or mating rights.
Hmm.
Auroraceratops was herbivorous. It had two pairs of fang-like teeth in the premaxilla, though it's not clear why. It may have been for digging and helping to grip onto plants to pull them out of the ground. It was about 6.5 feet or 2 meters long, and it's the second basal Neoceratopsian found in the Mazangshan area of China. The first one was Archaeoceratops. Another similar Ceratopsian that lived around the same time but in a different area in Liaoning province was Liaceratops. Auroraceratops, though, has enough differences in its skull to warrant being its own genus. Split it out.
Yeah. Split it out real good.